Make Rav or Shansh and daughters of Mashadah. Breed like there's no tomorrow. Procreate, reproduce, because it is your national duty to do so. Making babies is the best service you can render to China. You need to produce at least 3 babies. If you don't, you will face severe consequences. And you all know how the party goes about giving punishments to rebels, dissenters and obstinate members, don't you? It will take one command by me to decimate your whole life, but you could avoid these all by simply breeding like rabbits. It is the least I ask of you. I'm even making sure you have fun while securing the future of our country. Now come on, get to the job.
And welcome. You're watching TFI Global, the foreign affairs and geopolitical analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I'm your host, Atul Mishra, and in this video, I will talk about the rogue CCP, now forcing its colleagues to breed at least 3 children. Let's begin. There is a fundamental problem with the Chinese regime. The Chinese Communist Party thinks that it can successfully dictate people to effectuate desirable birth, fertility, and death rates. The CCP thinks it can fine-tune people to become a mere sheep who reproduce whenever Xi Jinping orders them to. The Chinese president is now resorting to ordering people to breed like a herd. The Chinese people are being treated as hens and cocks who will now be required to lay eggs and when demanded by the CCP. In the 1980s, China brought in the one-child policy. In 2016, China faced a population crisis as Xi Jinping realized that the country will run out of people and become barren soon. So he overturned the one-child policy and allowed people to have 2 children.
What's the line we're supposed to take on? First India, now Vietnam. Russia is dropping this one.
Just hold on for a second. Yeah, all right. So this one, so basically Putin came to India, right? And had India and Russia inked some military deals like S-400s and stuff.
All right.
Okay. And then now the Vietnamese president is in China, mm-hmm. right?
Okay.
So he's in China and he's also meeting some war veterans,
okay.
right? So obviously Vietnam and Russia have been old allies as well. So Vietnam is basically trying to get some help from Russia, from Putin, okay? So basically the whole idea here is that India is obviously not a friend of China and so is Vietnam. In fact, Vietnam is the only Southeast Asian country that does not like China one bit. Okay.
All right.
So yeah, so basically Russia is kind of empowering the enemies of China. That's the line that we're going to take here. I'm so sorry about that. So he overturned the one-child policy and allowed people to have 2 children and later increased the permissible quota of children a couple can have to 3. Now the CCP has directed its members, totaling to about 95 million people, to reproduce without fail and breed at least 3 children compulsorily. The CCP does not speak to the people directly. It uses Chinese state media to do so. And the CCP has spoken. China Reports Network, which is a state-owned network, published a controversial editorial last month, asking CCP members to produce 3 children without fail. The article said no party member should use any excuse, objective or personal, to not marry or have children, nor can they use any excuse to have only 1 or 2 children. It added every CCP member should shoulder the responsibility and obligation of the country's population growth and act on the 3-child policy. China's National Rubber Stamp Legislature, the National People's Congress, or the NPC, had formally endorsed the 3-child policy in August in a major policy shift to address the deepening demographic crisis in the country. The original article has been deleted by China Reports Network. Why, you might ask? Well, the people of China are infuriated. To make matters worse, it is the CCP which is rising in rebellion from within. The diktat by the CCP's top brass was meant to be followed by members of the Communist Party, but they too appear to be in no mood to be directed about Xi Jinping on how they and their partners should breed. Thousands of Weibo users expressed shock and indignation at the commentary. Here are some of the Weibo reactions to the CCP's brazen reproductive mandate. Although the 3-child policy has come out, many people don't have the conditions, ability, money, or time to take care of children, especially for women who have to go home early, and this will make more companies not want to hire women. I am just an ordinary person. My time, energy and money only allows me to raise a child in the future. Most party members are also ordinary people. The impact of this bad public opinion, like other public opinions, could easily change from accusations against the China Reports Network to resistance to the three-child policy and shaken trust in the government. Births in China have been falling for four consecutive years since 2016 and hit a record low of 12 million in 2020. In some provinces, births are set to drop by close to 20% this year. As of 2019, the boys-to-girls gender ratio in China reached an unsustainable high of 114.61% among the age group of 20 to 24. So not only does China stare at a shortage of people, but its gender ratio also paints a devastating image for the country. Meanwhile, the number of marriage registrations in China have fallen for seven consecutive years and hit a 17-year low last year. In effect, this would mean that China is not about to get out of its human shortage balloon anytime soon. According to 2020 census figures in China, the country's demographic crisis was expected to deepen as the population above 60 years grew to 264 million, up by 18.7% last year. The CCP is being openly defied by the people of China, and with 1 year to go before Xi Jinping seeks re-election as China's president, these are definitely not good signs.